teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say, 'cause they're the ones who's coming up and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. Oh, yeah.
Hello, welcome back to the Teacher's Cup of Coffee. I hope everyone's doing well out there. I'm your host, Timothy Allen. So excited to be here with you. It is the Monday of a three-day weekend. It's really the first three-day weekend of the school year. I really find it to be such a good checkpoint for where we are as educators. The next few weeks, dare I say it, are pivotal. You know, we're kind of coming out of sort of everything's fine, everything's good. It's the beginning of the year. We all have our routines and procedures in place. And I would say that in the next 4 or 5 weeks, we do some of our deepest learning with students, and we also start to see their true colors, and we might start to get more stressed, more things start piling up, we get further behind, and then we also just sort of figure out what vibe is this school year going to have for us. So much takes place between this three-day weekend and around Thanksgiving. It's such an important time of the school year. So the question is, what will our reaction be? How will we deal with this? What type of year are we going to have? Are we going to sink into one of those negative years that we all wish we could avoid, or are we going to find a way to keep rising and keep improving and have a very positive year? And that is why today I'm issuing sort of a challenge. The title of this one is, which one are you? Which one are you? And the question is, are you an idea generator or are you an idea terminator? Are you an IG or an IT? Do you generate ideas, generate new thinking, generate creativity with the way you teach and the way you interact with kids? Or do you terminate new ideas, terminate creativity? And all of this takes place in both your reactions and interactions with staff and with students. So are you an idea generator or are you an idea terminator? First, I will quickly go through what each one looks like. Then I'll give you some suggestions of how you can really focus in the next few weeks, these pivotal weeks, on being an idea generator. First of all, idea generators typically talk to colleagues and students to brainstorm new ideas often. Idea generators are always conversing with somebody, be it students or colleagues, and they're looking for new ideas, new thoughts, and creativity. Idea generators typically get excited by change, or they at least get intrigued by change, or they at least acknowledge that change could help, right? So if you can even just acknowledge things aren't good, here's a new idea that's been presented, let me think about it, right? Then you're kind of being an idea generator because you're not stopping the idea, you're helping it grow. Idea generators typically find themselves having conversations focused on how to make things better. We all vent. I do, you do, we all need these moments. But the question is, do we vent for a minute and then generate ideas and problem solving for the next 10 minutes? Or do we spend all 11 minutes just venting? Because if you're venting for too long, it's no longer venting. Now it's complaining. Venting is when you say some things just to get it off your chest so you can move on. Complaining is when you incessantly talk about what's wrong or the negative, and that is not the conversations that idea generators have. Idea generators also typically self-reflect on their instruction. You know, so many people walk away from a lesson and just think about what the kids could do or couldn't do and what was their fault, what wasn't. Idea generators are the opposite. We walk away from instruction and we reflect on what went well and what could we do differently. And really important, idea generators typically have authentic conversations with students. These are conversations that if you heard them objectively, you wouldn't know it was a student and a teacher. You wouldn't know someone had all the power and someone didn't. You would think that it was just two people talking. There's back and forth, there's listening on both sides, there's questioning on both sides. These are the type of authentic conversations that idea generators have with students. And most importantly, for idea generators, work usually feels like a mission. No matter what that mission is, it feels like a mission. My mission is to help kids learn science better. My mission is to reach my most at-risk students. My mission is to have the most exciting lessons. Whatever the mission is, for idea generators, work feels like a mission. Now, let's talk about idea terminators. For idea terminators, typically, if you listen to yourself closely, you'll hear a lot of complaining. Remember, idea terminators go past quick venting and they go right into complaining, defining what is wrong for long periods of time and never looping out of that cycle. Idea terminators are also experts at poking holes in thoughts and ideas. These are the people in education that if something new comes down the pike, all they can do is point out what's wrong with it. We all can point out some stuff that's wrong with new ideas. I'll talk about that in a minute. But the idea terminators, they just cut it to shreds. They point out everything they can that's wrong with it, never seeing any good. Idea terminators also, pretty much for the most part, a lot of what they do, they did the same thing 5, 10 years ago. So idea terminators have sort of found this rhythm where there's not much change day to day, week to week, month to month, or even year to year. They just have the things they do and they continue to do them. And also, idea terminators, when you hear them talking with students, it's going to be a lot of one-way conversation. The educator is going to be in charge and the student is not. And it's more like telling you what to do differently, telling them things. And the student, if you listen in objectively, you would know it was a student because they'd be giving very short answers. Yes, okay, uh-huh, I will. Those kind of answers. Those are not authentic conversations. Those are teacher to student or educator to student conversations. And for idea terminators, work feels like work. It feels like work. That's what it is. There's not a lot of joy in it for idea terminators. And that's why it's so important to be an idea generator. So how do we make sure that we either become idea generators or that we stay as idea generators? First of all, idea generators, they generate ideas and they start talking about them often. So if you haven't had an idea in a while, start talking to people, start coming up with ideas, little ones, big ones. How can students transition better? How can we work with Johnny better? Little ones, and start talking about them. And then as you do this, you're going to notice other idea generators. And that's so important. You know, you have to find the other idea generators because when you talk to them, you'll feel refreshed and you'll feel ready to go. So start talking about little ideas and then go find idea generators and talk to them often. I challenge you, if you want to be an idea generator, set a deadline for you to have a new instructional idea for your classroom. So maybe this week you say, by Friday, I'm going to come up with something new that I'm going to do next week in my classroom. You won't even believe how good it feels to set this deadline, work to this deadline, and then the following week start implementing something new. You will feel refreshed. Work will begin to feel like a mission again. And then I want you to really watch closely for the next time an idea comes your way. I don't care who the idea comes from. It could come from the colleague you like the least. It could come from the administrator that doesn't know what they're doing. It doesn't matter. Wherever the idea comes from, watch for that idea. And then in the moment it's presented, if you feel yourself shutting down to it, stop it. Say, no, I need to be an idea generator right here in this moment. And listen to the idea. Accept it without judgment. We're gonna make judgments, of course, but in the moment it's being presented to you, don't start poking holes. Listen to the new idea and accept it without judgment. Then step away. Even if you decide you dislike that new idea, spend some time thinking about it, really thinking about it, and find some good in the idea. What is good about the idea? So you're not just poking the holes, you're also figuring out what is good. Then follow up with the person that had the idea. Follow up with a conversation. Follow up with a, here's, you know, what I liked about your idea and why I think it's important. Here's some ideas I have to build off of it that might help it improve. Another thing idea generators can do, this is one of my favorite things to do, this is really what generates this whole podcast for me, is read something new, then share it with someone else. So find something that looks interesting to read. Sometimes 2 pages in an article can really change our thinking. Read it, think about it, and then share it with someone else. Find another idea generator and say, I found this to be really interesting. I think you will too. It's not that hard to become an idea generator, but we need to talk to other idea generators to sort of get ourselves going. We need to set deadlines to create new ideas. We need to watch closely when ideas are presented at us, that we don't just start poking holes, that we listen without judgment. Then later on, we go back, point out the positives, and talk about some ways to improve it. And lastly, we need to read. We need to read. I heard a great quote this week. If you don't have time to read, then you don't have time to lead. And that works so well for both educational leaders, but teachers and counselors, all of us are leaders. You're leading, some of you, 120 students a day. And if we don't have time to read, we don't have time to lead. So read something new and then share it out. Don't be an idea terminator. This is a pivotal time of the school year. Over the next 5 weeks, if you become an idea terminator, I promise this is going to feel like a very long and stressful school year. But if you can work on becoming or staying an idea generator, you're going to feel revived more than you know, and you're going to have a very positive school year. If you're an idea generator, you'll feel more effective, you'll feel more creative, you'll feel more fulfilled, and most importantly, you'll feel happier in education. So be an idea generator. Again, thank you for joining us here on the Teacher's Cup of Coffee. My name is Timothy Allen. Check us out, NPT Education, on Twitter at NPT Education or NPTEducation.com. We have blogs, podcasts, video blogs, and thank you for joining us here on the Teacher's Cup of Coffee.
Yeah, no better. We gotta change it, yeah. Just you and me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.